Welcome to all of you. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about design of 3-bit counter using 7476. It has three headings. First part is the description about 7476, then design of 3-bit asynchronous up counter, then design of 3-bit asynchronous down counter using 7476 IC. Let us have a brief overview of 7476 IC. The 7476 is a 16-pin IC and it internally consists of two JK flip-flops. And these two JK flip-flops are independent of each other. So this is going to be the first JK flip-flop and this is going to be the second JK flip-flop. So in this diagram, we can make an observation of two independent JK flip-flop configuration. So which are all represented with the suffix 1 that corresponds to the first JK flip-flop, and which are all with the suffix 2, they are all corresponds to the second JK flip-flop. The first JK flip-flop has J1, then K1, Q1, Q1 bar, clock, preset and clear. The second JK flip-flop, J2, K2, then Q2, Q2 bar, then clock 2, preset 2 and clear 2. So in each of these flip-flops, we have to observe that the clock, preset as well as the clear, all these three are active low. So few words about it. 7476 is a 16-pin IC, consists of two independent JK flip-flops. So preset, clear are active low inputs. Preset, clear are asynchronous inputs. Asynchronous in the sense, it is not dependent on the clock. Based on the values given to the preset and clear, it is going to change the output values. Then clock is also active low. Before getting into the design of the counter, let us have a view of the functional table of JK flip-flop. So this is the functional table of the JK flip-flops. So these are all are the inputs and these are all are the outputs. So within this functional table, we are going to make use of one specific criteria in order to design the counter, that is the toggle condition. So for the toggle condition, the preset is equal to 1, clear is equal to 1, then J and K must be kept equal to 1, then we are going to have the toggle condition at the output. So using this toggle condition, we are going to make a design of counter, and always the clock is the falling edge. Now let us get into the 3-bit asynchronous up counter design. So this is the truth table. So let us have a proper splitting of this 3-bit, then asynchronous, then the up counter. So why we are going to say it as a 3-bit? So we are going to make use of 3 JK flip-flops for this, and each flip-flop will have one output. So there are total 3 output bits we are going to have. Therefore we call this as a 3-bit counter. Why it is called asynchronous? So the term asynchronous indicates that the clock is given only to the very first stage of the connection, and then the subsequent stages, the output of the previous stage will become clocked to the next stage. So that's why the configuration is the asynchronous manner. Up counter in the sense, so it is going to start from the minimum value and move towards the maximum value. That has been shown over here. So the minimum value, it is always 000. The count value starts from 000 and ends with 111 with a sequential increment. After 111, again it will go back to 0 and this cycle continues. So that's why it is called an up counter. The waveform for this up counter is represented over here. And here we have to observe that, so at the falling edge of the clock, there is a change in the output. And with respect to this waveform and the truth table, if you make a match, then the QA, which is LSB in the waveform, will match with that of the Q0, which is the LSB over here. And then QB matches with the Q1, and QC, which is the MSB, that matches with the Q2, and Q2 is the MSB over here. So for the further discussion, wherever this type of waveform is going to appear, then it indicates that the QJ, Q0 matching, QB, Q1 matching, and QC, Q2 matching. Now let us get into the connection representation of this 3-bit asynchronous up counter. So these are the overall connection we are going to have. And again, remember, we are going to keep this complete configuration of each of these flip-flop connection in a toggle mode. Toggle mode in the sense, you have to remember, preset clear is equal to 1, J and K are equal to 1. So with that configuration, we are going to have further connection. We will have a step-by-step description of this connection. So let us get into these words first. So preset and clear are connected to VCC. J and K are shorted and connected to VCC. That is, to keep them in the toggle condition, then clock is given to the first stage, and for subsequent stages, output of the previous stage will be the clock input for the present stage. Then Q is the output from each stage of flip-flop. Right? So let us make a follow-up of these sentences one after the another, and let us make the circuit step by step. So let us start the circuit. So we are going to have three flip-flops. So while making the explanation, I am always referring to the flip-flops instead of 7476. But you need to remember that the 7476 internally consists of JK flip-flops, and we are making use of those JK flip-flops in order to design a counter. So each 7476 consists of two JK flip-flops. If I am designing a 3-bit counter, in the sense, I require three JK flip-flops. So when we make it in comparison with 7476, we require two 7476 ICs. So first two of the JK flip-flops will be configuring with one 7476, and anything more than that need to have one more 7476. So first two JK flip-flops will be from one 7476, and in continuation, the third one will be used from one more 7476 IC. So anyhow, for the sake of understanding, we always deal with the representation of the flip-flops. Therefore, the three flip-flops are being represented here. And you need to remember, so we are making use of the flip-flops present inside 7476 IC. So let us go with the connection. So these are the three flip-flops we are going to have. Let us start with the first connection. So first connection is the both preset and clear are connected to VCC. So why we need to connect that to VCC? That is from the functional table. We have to keep this in the toggle condition. So with respect to toggle condition, what are all the requirements? We are just making the configuration in that manner. So that is, preset is equal to 1 and clear is equal to 1. So make preset is equal to 1 and clear is equal to 1. So we are connecting preset all shorted and connected to VCC. That means input to this preset is equal to 1. Clear all are shorted and connected to VCC. That means input to the clear is equal to 1. So one more thing you need to remember over here. In any further representations, whichever the line that is being represented in the red color, that is the part of the explanation in that moment, and all other will become the previous representations. So now the second part. In the second part, we need to keep J and K is equal to 1 and 1. Therefore, J and K of each flip-flop has been shorted, so that you can observe over here, and all of them together being given to VCC. VCC in the sense, the input to J and K of all these three flip-flops are now equal to 1. So inputs are being set, that is preset clear is done, J and K are done, now remaining with the clock part. Now here we can observe the clock. So as it has been given in the explanation, the clock will be given to the first flip-flop, and this clock represents the clock present in the trainer kit. either 1 hertz clock or the monopulse. So from there it will be taken and that will be given to the clock of the very first JK flip-flop. Then for the subsequent stages, output of the previous stage will become the clock for the present stage. So that's why here Q will become the clock for this stage, and then output of this one, that is from Q, that will become the clock for this one. And also we are defining the output over here. So this is the first output, the LSB bit, that is Q0, and next one is this Q1, and next one is this, that is Q2, is the MSB part. So now we have done all with the connection. So a simple connection we are going to have, and we have all done with that connection. Let us proceed with the counting operation. Okay, now once the configuration has been done, now it starts with the counting operation. So from where we have to start? We have to start from the count 000. And one thing you have to remember. So all JK inputs are being given to the VCC, in the sense all of them will always have the value 1 at all moments. Right? So initially we are going to make an assumption that the output bit of each flip-flop is having the value 0. So that's why, so here it is 0 represented, here also 0, and here also 0. So with respect to truth table, we are at the very beginning stage. Right? And the clock, the waves that has been represented over here, so they are also representing the 000 value. Now at this stage, when we are when the output are 0, now we are going to apply the clock pulse for this one. Now let us see what happens. Now the clock pulse has been applied. Now when the clock pulse is being applied over here, then since the flip-flops are being configured in a toggle condition, the output which was 0 will have a toggle, and that changes to the value 1. So that has been happened over here. Right? So that is for this flip-flop. Then what about this flip-flop? Now this value which was 0, that has got changed to 1, and that 1 will be applied to this clock pulse. But JK flip-flop will only get triggered at the falling edge of the clock, not at the rising edge of the clock. Therefore, change from 0 to 1 of this output will not have any effect on this clock pulse or on this JK flip-flop. Therefore, this JK flip-flop is not going to have any changes with respect to the output. And this 0 is being given to the next flip-flop clock. So this 0 will remain as a 0. So this also is not going to have any changes with respect to the output. So no falling edge is being occurring over here. Therefore, here also no change is happening. Now what is the output, final output we are going to have? Q2 is 0, Q1 is 0, Q0 is now equal to 1. So output is equal to 0, 0, 1 we are going to have. So now we are at this stage, 0, 0, 1 we have got. With respect to waveform, you can observe at the falling edge of the clock, the LSB bit has got changed from 0 to 1, and others are still remaining at 0. Therefore, output is 0, 0, and 1 we are having. At this stage, again, we are going to apply the clock pulse. Let us see what happens. Now, at this stage, when we apply the clock pulse, then again, clock is being applied over here. Again, there will be a toggling operation. That means the value which was 1 will get toggled, and that will change to 0. So now we are having a value 0 over here. Now what about the next JK flip-flop? So there is a transition from 1 to 0 at this point, right? There is a transition from 1 to 0 at this point. So that will be given to the clock over here, and that is going to act as a falling edge of the clock. Therefore, this flip-flop will get toggled. Therefore, the output which was 0, now it has changed to 1. Right? So a 0 to 1 transition occurred over here, and when the same has been applied to this JK flip-flop, then there is no change with respect to this, because this one is having rising edge of the clock that has been applied over here. For that rising edge of the clock, this flip-flop is not going to work. It will work only at the falling edge of the clock. Therefore, the output of this JK flip-flop remains as 0 only. So now what is the output? Output is Q2 is 0, Q1 is 1, Q0 is equal to 0. Therefore, 0, 1, 0 is the output. So that is what we are going to have, 0, 1, 0. With respect to waveform, you can have clear understanding. Now we are at the falling edge of the clock that has been applied over here. Therefore, QA has changed from 1 to 0. When it changes from 1 to 0, a falling edge has been occurred, which will be given to the next JK flip-flop. Therefore, the state of the next JK flip-flop will have a toggling operation from 0 to 1. Then that 0 to 1 change will be given to the next JK flip-flop, which has no change on it. Therefore, that remains as 0 only. Therefore, we are going to have 0, 1, 0 as the output. The same procedure will keep continuing up to the last value 111 also. So let us have a simple view of it, and I expect you to trace further from this stage and onwards. So here we are going to have 011. So 011 we are going to have corresponding waveform is being represented. So I expect you to trace these things by yourself. So now this is 100 we are having. So with respect to waveform, you can observe very clearly output here 100 we are having. And then 110 further. The last value 111 we are going to have. And if you proceed further, then automatically it will go to 0, and then the count starts from the beginning, and this will keep going in a cyclic manner. So this is all about the up counter we are going to have. So this is what the circuit representation and analysis of that circuit, how it is going to work like, the truth table, step by step explanation, and then the waveform at each stage you can observe at each point. Now let us go with the design of a 3-bit down counter. So this is the truth table of the 3-bit down counter. So again, the same 3 bits we are going to have. Down counter in the sense, it is going to start from the maximum value and it is going to end up with the minimum value, and there will be decremental sequence we are going to have, highest towards the lowest. Once we got the lowest value, again it will go back to the highest value, and the cycle will keep repeating. Let us get into the circuit realization of the down counter. So what are all the circuit we have done with respect to the up counter? Almost all remains the same except one point that is represented in the red color over here. The clock to the first stage remains as it is. For the second and the subsequent stages, the clock input is going to change. So for the down counter, the clock input will be from the Q bar of the previous stage to the present stage of the clock. Then Q bar from here to the present stage of the clock. Except this, there will be no further changes. This Q0, Q1, Q2 itself is the output for this also. So by this small variation, we are going to have the down counter operation. So here I have represented just 3-bit up counter as well as 3-bit down counter. So if you want to make a 4-bit counter design, then no problem. The same circuit, we will have one more JK flip-flop in 7476. We can make use of that. And whatever the circuit we have done, the same replica will keep continuing. So that is going to give us the 4-bit counter design, either up counter or the down counter. So for the down counter here, what the 3-bit I had shown over here. I'm not going to make the explanation. You can just make an experiment of it and you can have the output of it. Thanks for joining.